Julia and Erica, I'm going to take a wild guess here and say you've probably had friends ask you what the heck is going on at LA City Hall. For our friends who haven't been following, here's a quick review. Every attempt by the city council to meet becomes a raucous demonstration against council member Kevin DeLeon. DeLeon says he won't resign in the wake of the leaked audio tape of a racist conversation that he participated in. And the councilman most recently got into a physical altercation with an aggressive protester at a Christmas event in front of children who left in tears. Julia, you cover City Hall. Is all of this drama affecting the council's ability to actually do its work?
Absolutely. Although I will say they had two very major things they passed in Tuesday's meeting, which is their final meeting before the winter recess. One was approving Mayor Karen Bass's state of emergency on homelessness, and the other was a one-month extension in COVID-19 eviction protections. And there were a lot of questions about whether or not they would be able to have those votes on Tuesday. There was so much kind of chaos going on. Once KDL entered the room, there was a very lengthy standoff, and it was unclear if they were going to be able to get back to work.
And he eventually, I guess, cast his vote from a back room, which we all found out is apparently permitted. Erica, there is already a level of distrust among many Angelenos when it comes to the LA City Council, and that was before the leaked audio tape. Three council members, I believe it is, either convicted or indicted on corruption charges in the past couple of years. How is the DeLeon situation playing into how the citizens of LA feel about the council and about city government in general?
I mean, I definitely don't think it's helping the trust factor. As you mentioned, there was already kind of just not a skepticism and a cynicism about city politics. And I think this has just fed into that. I mean, as Julia mentioned, it was really unclear about whether this vote on these very two crucial issues was even going to pass. I mean, we're talking about keeping people who are housed and allowing people who are homeless to be housed. And there's a real question about whether the council is actually going to be able to take action on that. And so I think it just doesn't help the citizen trust in city government to actually get anything done and to actually meet the needs of the people.
DeLeon has 2 years left in his term. There is a recall effort underway, but even if that moves forward, what are the chances, Julia, that DeLeon leaves before his term is up? Do you expect this is just going to be the new normal for the city council if he stays in office?
That's a great question. So he has been very clear. He does not plan to resign before his term is over. And there is no way for his fellow council members to remove him. So were he to go, recall is the only way. And the thing to know about recalls is it's pretty easy to start a recall attempt, and it's actually really hard to qualify one for the ballot. In this case, they would have to collect about 25,000 signatures to have a buffer for ones that are rejected. And that's a really large number that you probably need paid signature gatherers for. So it's also an expensive effort. They have until, I believe, March to do so. So we'll see what happens, but it's an uphill climb. And then, of course, he'd have to lose that recall election in order to actually be out. It's not enough just to qualify.
And just so I'm clear, those signatures that have to be collected, is that within his district or is it citywide?
Exactly, within CD 14, his district, which is Boyle Heights, parts of downtown. Other parts of the east side.
Of course, all of this takes place against the backdrop of a new mayor in town. Karen Bass went to work this week. Erica, there is a lot of hope attached to her taking office, but here's what you said in a column in the LA Times this week. There are many things working against Bass. Of course, chief among them are apathy and disillusionment. Then there's the tiresome toxic masculinity that has taken root in the Los Angeles City Council. What did you mean by that part of the column? And then how will this mayor get past the council dramas to get things done?
I mean, I think that when I was talking about toxic masculinity, if I could have written that looking forward to Tuesday, I mean, I think seeing Kevin DeLeon sitting in that, you know, at the horseshoe by himself for an hour, basically holding up city business and kind of holding the city hostage is like the biggest example of that I've seen thus far. And I think that, you know, how we get past that's going to be tough. I mean, I think it's a matter of, you know, the city council leadership hoping, you know, working with Kevin DeLeon for a way for people to be able to meet and actually vote. That has not gone well so far. We saw the council president try to talk Kevin DeLeon down. He did leave the chamber. There was a bit of a cat and mouse game, which members leaving, members coming back in. You know, I hate to say this is the new normal, but I don't see a lot of changes going forward. And in part too, because activists are not backing down either. I had a long conversation with some activists the last couple of days, and they don't plan on changing their tactics either. So this is going to be really interesting come January.
It sure is. All right. Erika Smith and Julia Wick from the Los Angeles Times. Thank you both for your time.
Thanks for having us.